The one question I always receive from radiographer students is this, which is better, public or private? The short answer is, it depends on your life circumstance. I know it's a lame answer, but you want different things depending on your life stages. Take me for an example. 7 years ago, I was young and single and had no financial commitment, so I could take on temporary jobs or work in a rural area for better opportunity. Now, I'm married and I'm starting a family, also have a mortgage now, so a steady paycheck and regular hours are my priorities. I definitely cannot take the same risk as I did 7 years ago. Before I do the comparison, here's a little bit about my background. I did placements in public hospitals, and private clinics in both metropolitan and rural areas during my radiography student time. I did a 6-month internship in metropolitan public hospital. After graduation, I worked in 2 different private clinic companies for 18 months. Since 2015, I have been working in a metropolitan public hospital. At the time of my graduation, I did not have a career direction and did not know where I want to be. But after working in 2 different private companies for 1.5 years, I realized that's not what I wanted. I didn't like regular 9-to-5 schedule. I prefer to have afternoon shifts so I can do anything I want in the morning. Also, I miss the adrenaline rush of working in emergency and theaters. So I went back to a public hospital, and that's where I will stay for the rest of my life because I love it. Before I get into the details, I would like to just give a small piece of advice to the new graduates. Don't be too picky at the start. Take any job anywhere you can find. Especially there aren't that many job vacancies right now. The hiring team would choose someone who has been working the entire time over someone who hasn't been employed for a while. Choose the job that will give you more clinical exposure and growth. Gain more experience, and then you can be choosy and negotiate for a better salary. So I got some questions from the audience, and let's talk about them. Original workplace backward. No. They are original hospitals with better or worse equipment. The odd is the same with metropolitan hospitals. Same with the private sector. Some private clinics have state-of-the-art facilities. On the other hand, I have seen some rundown clinics with outdated machines. If you're going for a job in original workplace, and if it's possible for you to travel to there, it is definitely worthwhile to pay a visit so you can check out the workplace and leave a good impression. Is it true that there is a queue to be trained in advanced modalities in metropolitan area? Before we dive deep into the answer, the term advanced modality is variable in different places. In some workplaces, CT can be considered as an advanced modality, so there is a queue to be trained in there. Whereas in my hospital, CT is considered as part of general radiography, so everyone gets the training. On the other hand, in my hospital, MRI is a specialty area and only trained staff can work in there. However, I know in other hospitals, general radiographers are rostered in MRI as part of a routine. So at the end of the day, it depends on the size and the management of the radiology department. It is partially true that there is a queue to be trained up in the metropolitan area. There is definitely fewer competitions in the regional area, and sometimes the regional hospital or clinic would promise training positions in order to attract new staff. I worked in this hospital for 1.5 years before starting my MRI training, roughly 3 years after my graduation. On average, from what I have seen so far, most of my year level graduates get into a specialty within 5 years after graduation in both metropolitan and rural settings. Some radiographers would choose to work in a clinic rather than a hospital in hope of getting ultrasound or MRI training sooner. I know someone who started ultrasound training after 1 year, but I also know someone who started ultrasound training after 15 years. Sometimes it is down to your preference. It depends if you feel like you're ready to take on a challenge at that point in your life. Is it better to go regional to get trained sooner? Yes and no. Let me give you a few different scenarios. If you have the option of working in a regional hospital versus working in a metropolitan private clinic, I would recommend going to the regional hospital because you will have more clinical experience in a hospital setting comparing to a clinic environment. If you're going to a regional clinic with a promise or training opportunity, kind of depends on the situation. If the regional clinic offers an ultrasound training position, it might be worth it because ultrasound training spots are in demand. But if they're only offering new CT training, it might not be as attractive because CT training is widely available in metropolitan area. Now, if you're promised to receive training opportunity that you want in a regional place, it might be worth spending a few years there. And who knows, you might fall in love with the region and decide to settle there. Is it easier to get the first job in private sector comparing to public sector? Yes, in my opinion. It is a little bit easier to find a job in private because there are more people who want to work in public for a different variety of reasons. Additionally, you need a larger skill set to work in a public hospital. For example, theater II skill, mobile radiography, and fluoroscopy. And you don't get those skills from working in a clinic. Therefore, it could be a little tricky for someone to transit from private clinic to a public hospital. Take me as an example. I found private clinic jobs quickly after graduation. But a year later, I realized that I want to work in a public hospital. It took me around 6 months before I was hired again in a public hospital, and I was rejected by several hospitals before that. What is shift work like? In a public hospital, you work 24/7, meaning you could start your shift at 6 a.m. or working overnight from 9 p.m. to 7 a.m. or being on call over the entire weekend, like getting a phone call at 2 a.m. on Sunday morning. In a private hospital, there might not be any overnight shifts, but they possibly are on call duties and weekend shifts. In clinics, a majority of shifts are 9 to 5. There is no on-call duty and is unlikely to have any weekend shifts. So very often, some radiographers in their middle age would transit from a hospital to a clinic for a more stable work-life balance, so they don't have to do any more night shifts or on-call duty. What are the main differences between working in private and public, except night shift? Well, you get different types of stress and exposures. In a hospital, you look after patients from emergency, intensive care, and trauma settings. You will need to look after immobilized and critically ill patients. So it is emotionally and physically demanding. At the same time, you are more likely to work in different modalities such as CT, X-ray, MRI, mammography, fluoroscopy, angiography, cath lab, theater, and ultrasound. On the other hand, in a clinic, you'll be exposed to fewer modalities, and you also need to meet a strict time schedule and try to perform scans on all the patients who are waiting impatiently in the waiting area. It is common that you are the only radiographer in the modality, so there is no one else there to give you a hand when you fall behind in schedule. That's why when you choose your student placements, you should choose different types of clinical settings so you can see for yourself. Should I choose a private job due to job security? Public or private, it all comes down to the contract you sign. A lot of the time, you see public hospital advertising temporary positions such as maternity leave and long service leave covers. It could be a little unsettling. But if you can prove yourself to be a good team member, most of the time, the department will try to extend your contract or turn your job into a permanent one. I, for example, left a permanent job in a private clinic in order to take a 6-month temporary position in this hospital. A few years later, they changed my contract into a permanent one. That was a risk to take, but it was worth it at that time because I was still at the start of my career. During COVID, my job was secured because I work in the public sector, whereas my friend working for a private company was not so lucky. Her hours were cut in half, hence she lost half of her income, and some new staff were even let go in her company. Unfortunately, she couldn't ask for JobKeeper payment because the private company was not qualified for subsidies. So just because you get a permanent job in a private clinic, it doesn't always guarantee job security.